Each one of us is born with a legend waiting to be birthed.
Evolution is upon us.
We're about to reinvent what this world is.
I have an idea for this afternoon. It's to take a plague off the planet. So since humans have been walking this planet, they've been wrestling with some big problems. Harari, I don't know if anybody here has read the book Sapiens, but in Sapiens Deus, he reminds us that from the beginning of time, we've been trying to fight war, famine, and plagues. And sometimes when I wake up in the morning, I think, as I'm bombarded with the internet, could things actually get any worse? Like, you just feel like you see so much rise to the top that is depressing each morning, and you think, oh my God, is the planet getting darker? Are things actually getting worse? But raise your hand if you're around 25 years old, around in the vicinity. Okay, raise your hand if you're like me and you have a son that's around 25 years old. Oh, even less, but thank God mine's in the front row here. But in 25 years, amazing things have happened. The world has taken extreme poverty, which we've been fighting since the time of the pharaohs. That's people living on $1.25 or less a day, and we've cut that number in half. We've taken 85% of the population and made them literate. So now 85% of the people on the planet can read. Whether they want to read or not is a different story, but they can read. And then more child mortality, cut in half in 25 years. And Radlett, who has a great book called The Great Surge, says that despite conflict in Syria and things that we're seeing in our face, from ISIS to terrorist attacks, it actually might be the most peaceful time in history because we don't have the same mass wars. And then what about plagues? So the Black Plague in its day, in the Middle Ages, claimed 60% of all of Europe. 50 million people died. But now, we know plagues. We've cracked the code on modern pandemics. Look at AIDS, for an example. We know what causes it. We know how to prevent it. We know how to treat it. So it's not like, you know, bygone days where we can't figure it out and we're just left stunned. We actually have the tools and we know what we need to do. So what's happening is that in the last 25 years, we're bringing the world's number one health problem to its knees. And we've cut AIDS-related deaths in half. In sub-Saharan Africa, where two-thirds of those living with HIV reside, for the first time announced this week, half of the people living with HIV now have access to life-saving medication. That medication costs 30 cents a day, and so now 19 million people are alive that otherwise would have died from AIDS because we've gotten them the medication they need. And in 15, thank you, yeah. So, and in 15 years, as we saw in the video, we've reduced mother-child transmission by two-thirds, from 1,400 women a day passing HIV down to their babies to 400. 400, still a travesty. We've eliminated mother-child transmission in the United States and in Europe. But these are more than just metrics. When I was in Zambia, I met Connie. Connie had lost three children to HIV before they reached the age of five. I don't know what set of circumstances in life cracks a person, but the resiliency of Connie, who I met in a clinic, was, I'm going to become an AIDS activist. I am going to get rid of this stigma. And then she ended up having Labona, who's 5 years old and HIV free. So the United Nations has this audacious plan to end mother-child transmission of HIV by 2020. And the good news is, not the fake news, the real news, we're 90% of the way there. Like, it's a crazy thing. And the big idea then to get AIDS off the planet as a case study for humanity is that we can and will do it by the year 2030. So what was the other big idea that helped get this done? It was a marketing model that would just multiply and amplify compassion. And the idea was, okay, how do you get companies involved in taking a pandemic off the planet, which otherwise they would not be interested in? How do you get the most creative people, like the people here in this room, working for the poorest of the poor on the planet? And how do you get youth to feel like they're a part of a generation that Mandela said should just do the impossible and come up with a solution? Well, two rock stars in my eyes, my boss, Bono, from U2, and Bobby Shriver, created a meta brand. And the idea was to get iconic brands to have products where a portion would go to fight AIDS, and have celebrity and global influencers have experiences. It's a small case study in marketing innovation, but Red, you know, is a charity that acts like a brand. We are not for profit that acts like a startup. We are 20 people in a small office in Chelsea in New York. And as was just said, we're about to reach $500 million by the end of the year, working with our partners, many of whom I recognize here in this room. So it's no accident that we use those big parentheses to show the exponential power of this model. We use the mathematical paren, because the DNA of Red is to multiply your brand by the power of your customers, your brand to the power of your employees, influencers and celebrities to the power of their loyal fans. And it would be awesome if today we could land on a really big question. Is it so far-fetched that we could live in a world where every company stands for something noble? What if every single product was a product for good? What other global crisis can we defeat? Because the research shows from Cohn to Edelman that 75% of people in 23 countries expect companies to care about profit and social good equally, and that 90% now of consumers want to have a product that does some good on this planet. I am not talking about corporate philanthropy here. I am talking about putting your core values at the very center of the relationship that your brand has with its customers. So why not use the United Nations goals, their 17 sustainable goals, as a master checklist for humanity? Because we could take this idea and make it your model. Make it yours. Love your life, live your values, and leverage your tremendous, tremendous power. Love your life. Yeah, you blast music, wear your headphones, dance around the room, get that big ass iPhone, at sunset, ride that big sexy Vespa. But whatever you do, just don't buy the green one. Live your values. Get your Tom shoes for your friend's wedding. Get your Etsy mittens for your neighbor who's cold. View this beautiful world from your Warby Parker shades. Because brands like these and like ours are taking the idea of win-win and making it live-live. And so live your life so that others may live theirs. Now that's a concept. So these are the choices that let you leverage your power. To make a real difference at home, at work, you can show your true colors, red or otherwise. Because if I've learned anything in my career, it's that one person making the right choice can make a difference. But hell, a million people making the right choice, that's a world of difference. Thank you.
Guess I'm a bad liar. I see how your tension builds. It's like looking in